you'll be spending the day at Warwick Valley Winery and the Black Dirt Distillery, located in Warwick, New York. Co-founders of Black Dirt Distillery and Warwick Valley Winery, Jason Grizzanti and Jeremy Kidde, have been in the business of making alcohol-based beverages for over 25 years. With the opening of their newest production facility, Black Dirt Distillery, in 2012, the co-founders have expanded the production of their spirit products. The winery and distillery produce a wide range of products, including award-winning Doc's Cider. Warwick Valley Winery and Distillery has recently purchased a Rudolph Alcotest RI, and with the help of Darvin Martin from Rudolph Research Analytical, we would like to show you the many ways the Alcotest RI can be used in your winery and distillery. It is truly an all-purpose, time-saving instrument for a multi-product production environment such as a winery distillery. Rudolph Research Analytical makes it faster than ever to test the percent ABV value of alcoholic products with consistent accuracy using the new Alcotest RI. The Alcotest RI, which includes the TTB-approved DDM2911+ density meter, is a great way to measure the specific gravity of distiller's beer right before and right after fermentation to calculate the percent ABV of the finished beer. The results can be stored right on the instrument, so you can monitor your batches over time. This is a great way to monitor and maximize the percent ABV yield from your mash. Varying the mash bill, fermentation time, the yeast, and temperature will have an effect on the percent ABV yield of the finished distiller's beer.
I'm here with Jason among the fermentation tanks here. And how would you use a density meter to monitor your fermentation process?
So we could use the density meter to monitor the specific gravity of our incoming juice or wort. And then during fermentation, we can watch the gravity change and the sugars disappear as the alcohol content grows. So you can tell when the fermentation is done, or if something happens, if you have a stuck fermentation in the middle, you know what's going on, and it really allows for a lot of information during the fermentation process, which can normally be like sort of a black box.
So the ability to have a very quick analysis,
that's really
a quick result is important, and an accurate result.
The accuracy is paramount.
When making cuts from the still and when barreling, the highly accurate density meter component of the Alcotest RI can be used to measure percent ABV to make cuts and dilutions precisely and consistently every time.
Okay, I'm with Evan, head distiller here at Warwick Winery and Distillery. And we're in the distillation area. You're going to look at the process when you're making your cuts to determine your heads and tails?
Well, we start out running at, whatever temperature we have to get our yield. And then we'll use a couple samples to try to figure out what ABV we're at. And after that point, we'll run about 2 to 3 liters off, and that'll be our heads cut. As we distill furthermore, we kind of just pay attention to our yield coming off the still. Once we get the yield that we're expecting, then we'll pick up more samples, figure out the low ABV that is at the time, and we'll make our tails cut and our distillation.
So then with the Rudolph density meter, you can actually get a result for ABV in 45 seconds or so?
And consistent, yeah. That's the big plus.
The DDM2911+ also has onboard software for calculating dilutions as per the TTB gauging manual. This feature is called AlcoCalc. The TTB requires that obscured products like an apple pie moonshine be distilled in a lab still to remove just the water and alcohol so that the percent ABV can be measured in a TTB approved density meter or with a hydrometer. When blending down an obscured spirit, this might necessitate several hour-long distillations.
So Jason, can you talk about the process before you bought the instrument and your reasons for actually purchasing the instrument and the time savings?
So for the obscured spirits, we would measure out a sample and then we would run a distillation. And we still do this as our final alcohol check. But while we're blending, we can use this machine. So this machine now saves us, an hour every time we're getting ready to make any of our liqueurs or obscured spirits.
And since you can get results so quickly with this system, you can also use it to make adjustments to your batches.
Right. So we, you know, we would do a distillation, figure out what our alcohol was, where we needed to be, do our adjustment, do a second test distillation, make sure we were within our specifications, and then, you know, either do another one after an adjustment, or we would go into bottling. You're talking 5 hours of lab-sized distillation per blending bottling run. And, you know, now we've cut it down to two distillations and three Alcotest runs. Mm-hmm. So, 3-4 hours per day we did this sampling, which is great.
When using the Alcotest RI in production mode, the percent ABV measurements are quite accurate without distillation, even on obscured samples like wines and ciders. The refractometer sees the obscuration in the sample and is able to compensate for this when testing the density or percent ABV, since tax is paid by volume at a flat rate on these lower percent ABV products. Your main concern is being below the percent ABV limit. The Alcotest RI will be more than accurate enough for measuring these products. If you're a winery, distillery, or a combination of both, the Alcotest RI is the perfect instrument for your application, providing any and all alcohol-related testing in one system. It is really the ideal testing solution for all of the many testing activities that might be used in the making of high-proof spirits, wine, and cider. We enjoyed spending the day with Jason and wish the team well with their new instrumentation.